The first ever crewed mission of a Boeing Starliner is set to fly May 6th, and the astronauts are now on the ground at the Kennedy Space Center.
Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler was there when they landed and joins us live. Everyone set for the mission, Scott.
Arriving in T-38 aircraft, the first crew to fly a Boeing Starliner, now in Florida.
We love Kennedy Space Center because this is where you launch humans into space. And the opportunity finally to fly in here in our T-38s, and we know that in just less than 2 weeks, the next flight we take will be laying on our backs this time.
Their mission is an important one for Boeing, finally getting a crew to test in the delayed Starliner program. It's flown twice, but without astronauts. And for NASA's Commercial Crew Program, the Starliner was to be tag-teaming with SpaceX's Crew Dragon, taking astronauts up to the International Space Station. Starliner providing critical redundancy to the ISS from American soil. I asked the commander and pilot.
Clearly there's camaraderie amongst astronauts. What have some of your maybe friends, colleagues that have flown in Dragon said about comparing possibly Starliner, and what have you said in return?
There is so much with this spacecraft, the capabilities of this spacecraft, that other spacecraft don't have.
I honestly think it's a great stepping stone as we're getting ready to leave low Earth orbit and go back to the moon. It has a lot of similar things that Orion has. So I think if I was a young astronaut and I was thinking about going to the moon, I think I'd put my hand up and say, I want to fly Starliner.
It's going to be an exciting time. Of course, we'll carry that launch for you live right here on WESH.